De omgeving van de abdij is werkelijk uniek, schitterend mooi. Honderden fietsers, duizenden fietsers per jaar komen hier langs, gaan naar de restaurants en hebben het erg naar plezier. Je kan alle kanten de bossen induiken en veilig. Maar deze 300 meter van een ingang van de bossen links en rechts is levensgevaarlijk. En het is eigenlijk maar 300 meter bos, gedeelte bos, ruw hout. En om dat weg te halen, en je hebt een veiligheid voor duizenden fietsers. En dat is erg jammer dat dat nog niet snel en eigenlijk niet snel genoeg. Ik snap het niet, want dit is 8 kilometer lang. Na de bocht is er 8 kilometer verkeer. Daar hebben ze al een grensje opgezet van 70 kilometer. Dat zal redelijk misschien nageleefd worden, maar ik denk het niet. Maar het fietspad durf ik zelf niet meer op. Ik ga zeker niet meer die 8 kilometer fietsen op zo'n drukke weg. Aan weerskanten, te smal, te gevaarlijk. En dat doe ik echt niet.
I have very dramatic memories of where I was when the Beatles were on Ed Sullivan, when I heard that JFK had been shot. And this, I'll never get this memory out of my head, just where I was, just getting a phone call from a reporter. And they just said, have you heard the news? And I instantly knew what that meant. And that was just a total shock. Like, what do you say? It's like the world lost a John Lennon. I mean, Steve was clearly the most outstanding business thinker, and almost everybody who's high up in the technology business recognized that somehow he had the ability to think out new ways of doing things, not just ways to improve what we have, do a better version of something, but do it in a totally different way that the world would swing towards. And then I think back to just all the times we had together, very, very good times that you have when you're young, you know, and playing around with the systems and little misbehavior and doing interesting things. And then he was always thinking about certain technology, the early products that got developed, the building parts, what those might lead to in our future. And he was always pushing me as an engineer, could you possibly add this someday? Could you possibly add that someday? Yes, 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 I could, thinking, no, it's way, way off. But eventually we all did. We went into the garage when we were two young people with no money. You have to work out of your home. We had jobs on the side. We had nobody that could loan us money. We had no business experience. We're like a million young people who are so excited about the future they might have someday in business, making something just out of their ideas. That's what we were. And over and over and over, all the products of Apple, from, you know, iPhones and iPads, iPods, these were just unbelievable life changers. And almost everyone who heads a technology company looks at Steve Jobs as, where did he get the ideas to do it the right way? We were just the lucky partnership. He was lucky to have me in the beginning, but I am much, you know, incredibly lucky to him for everything in my life. He gets a reputation for being a strong leader and being brash, but to me, he was just always so kind, such a good friend, and I'm just going to miss him.
All right, Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, I really appreciate you talking to us. I know.